Welcome to the brand new Zenita 3D Blanks program. If you own or manage a digital print shop and are looking for that something special to grow your current offering into new categories, but you don't want to invest in new equipment, then this program is just for you. Zenita has selected a number of popular designs from our online store and from our extensive design library. We've then taken these designs and turned them into kits, packed each one into a box. Each box contains the actual unit pre-cut and flat-packed into its parts, together with all the necessary accessories nicely packaged in well-labeled plastic bags. The accessories generally include pre-cut lengths of edging, nuts and bolts, and anything else that is required to complete the assembly of the unit. In addition to the parts and the accessories, we have made it even easier for you and supplied thin card templates for all the typically printed surfaces. These templates can then be used to cut out the vinyl sections you print with your client's branding or messaging on it, so that when you apply these sections, they fit beautifully. It gets even better than that. We also supply in each box a detailed parts list and assembly instruction, so you know exactly how to put the unit together in front of your customer without missing any detail. In this stop frame clip, you will see exactly how the parts are packaged and how we show you all the steps of what you can do in your own shop to take the simple kit to a fantastic finished freestanding unit, ready to go to your client. Once you've laid out all your parts in a nice clean surface, you're ready to begin the assembly process. This particular unit, we start by laying out all the shelves and the footer of the unit onto a table surface. All the parts must have the V-cuts facing up. The glue we are going to use is simple cold glue, or otherwise known as wood glue. We find it speeds things up if we decant a little into a paint trough and apply the glue with a narrow paint roller like this one. Once you've applied the glue to the correct area, you fold the flap over and secure the bond by putting down something with a bit of weight on it on top of the part for about 10 minutes while the glue sets. Once the glue is dry, remove the weights and put the parts one side. Next up, we're going to glue on the shelf support strips to the side panels. Use the same cold glue as before and simply lay them into position as indicated by the pen marks on the side panel once you've applied your glue with the roller. Again, we put some weights down to ensure you get a good bond. The next step is to apply the edging provided in the packet and mark for which part it is to be applied. On this unit, we start with a header. First, lay the header down on your table and run the edging all around to make sure it's a good fit. Then you'll start applying hot melt glue to the edge of the board with a glue gun. Work on lengths of about 150mm beads at a time. We start in the center of the top edge, so that we don't end up on a corner, and it also the least visible place to join the edging at the end. And once you get to the end, you just trim off any excess edging with an art knife. Now be careful not to cut yourself. This process is then repeated with the two side panels as well, and this time we start at the back and the bottom corner. We work our way all around the part until we finish off at the front bottom corner and we trim off the excess edging. Now it's time to apply the foot protector, which has also been pre-cut to the correct lengths. Remember, the higher side is always facing towards the outside of the unit, and the lower side faces towards the inside of the unit. And as soon as all the prep work is done, you're ready to put the parts together. Best is to lay them on the ground so you can see all the parts. Start by inserting the back panel into the slots of the left side panel. Add your shelves and turn the unit upright. It should stand easily by itself now. Open the packet marked rods and insert one rod into the hole provided under each shelf and thread it through to the other side so that it comes out the back side of the side panel. Tighten the book screw by hand or by using a small coin and repeat this process for all the shelves. The second last task is to insert the footer panel, and then it is just a matter of securing the header with the book screws provided. Again, tighten them by hand or use a coin if it's easier. Step back and admire your work. The unit is complete.